start with, probably go to an easier species to start to give you guys kind of an idea on how it works. We're gonna go to single player game, and you'll see that I have some tents set up. So typically, when you start, your only option would be to spawn here if we were to pick this map. So this is White Hart Island. I could spawn here at the causeway, or I could spawn here at the South Cliff Lodge. That means you'd have to walk all the way around here if you wanted to hunt something there. You couldn't teleport anywhere. Same thing here. You'd have to walk all the way here, which can take a long time. So instead, we'll spawn at our tent, and we actually have a deployable hunting tower that's up where we maybe can hunt some elk or maybe hunt some other things. So we are going to spawn at the tent, and we'll go from there. So we'll start the game. And thank you guys for the follows, by the way. I'll remove this. And all right. So this will be a hunt. So when we go through and you hunt animals, couple things to keep in mind. The spook radius is a really big deal. Don't run or walk around like an asshole 90% of the time. Oh, hello. Okay, Rommel, you need to go in here, buddy. I won't be using you for this. Thank you for your services. So you'll spawn at either a lodge or a tent. In this situation, we spawned at a tent. So, knowing the species that are here, we have some deer species, we have some, let's see, we got coyotes here, we got turkeys, got elks. So I'm gonna take all this clothing off that I was using in winter, and I'm gonna change up my weapons and everything else. So we'll say we'll go with the field camo for here. I'm gonna click these and put on my field. Actually, fuck that, America. Don't need to use that. Summer field. Okay, so we're gonna put on that. And then, since I'm not in the winter, I don't wanna do that. I'm not gonna hunt any moose. So I'll bring a grunt call for deer. I'll bring a turkey call for turkey. I'll bring a coyote call. And notice that here, each weapon and item has a capacity. And because you have the backpack, it basically doubles the capacity from 10 to 20, which allows you to take a lot more stuff. So, we will bring. Probably just bring the Parker so I can kind of show you guys an idea on how the rangefinder sight works and why I think it's a good idea for newer players. And we'll bring our 223 for sure in case we get our coyotes. This damp is obsessed with them. And bring our coyote scope. And then we'll bring a little bit more ammo for the coyotes. I don't know that I want to bring this crossbow, so I'm going to take that back. Get rid of all the bolts. I don't need any deer feed or corn or bear feed, rather. So we'll bring our elk call because we know there's elk. And that's a turkey locator call. I'll bring that to show you guys in case that we need to use that. There's no pheasants that we give a shit about. Don't need to bring any large equipment. Don't need any scent eliminators, really. So we're going to bring one more gun. And I'll bring the 300 Win Mag so I can show you guys why I feel it's so good. Now, I'm not going to break it out right now because the coyotes sometimes will come up out of nowhere. And if they do, then we want to make sure that I have my rifle basically ready to go. So, We're gonna load everything. So we switch to 1 and 2, which are your primary and secondary weapon systems. So the bow's a little bit different. What you'll notice is based off your target with the bow, and it's kind of hard to tell because we don't actually have a target out there, but see the pins light up? That's where you would want to aim at the heart, at that pin. Or if it was a yellow pin, if it lit up, you'd want to aim the yellow. Whatever pin lights up is where you want to aim towards the heart and the lungs. So, so we have a bow, mostly for probably deer species. When the elk comes in, we'll switch weapons. But so the other thing you have here is the hunter mate. The hunter mate that we have allows us to track animals and allows us to really figure out where they're coming from. For example, on cue, there's a turkey. So that shows us, you can see the little icon there, right in this direction. There's a turkey being a real squawking bitch. So if we head this direction, we can get out our turkey call and it'll kind of come to us. Now, thing with turkeys is they see really, really good. So I'll begin to call that. And you can't overcall or undercall. I guess you could undercall, but typically you can't really overcall. Some people say that you can, but I've never noticed it. I don't think that's real. But one thing to cover real quick is not only the hunter mate, but how fast you're walking. So you have different stances. By hitting control, you can go prone. Then you hit shift, you go to crouch. Then you hit shift again, and you go to standing or walking. So whenever you're tracking an animal, you typically want to crouch 95% of the time. Unless it's really outpacing you, then you could walk. But the more stance, the faster you're walking, the more you're going to spook an animal. So you usually want to crouch. Oh, see? Got another call. She's still being a real bitch and yelling out. But you never really want to run, because the more you run or walk, like a run would have, let's say, a 200-meter spook radius. A walk might have a 100-meter spook radius. The more you walk or run, the more loud it is and the more likely you are to not find any animals. So I find it's a pretty good idea to just crouch and call. So we're going to try to move a little bit closer to the turkey and see if we can find her. Notice we're crouching. And we don't have to call all the time, but the female turkey doesn't give any points. So we'll pull out the male turkey call, the locator, in a little bit. But this is kind of where the patience falls in, because we're going to be kind of close to her, but we want to keep ourselves hidden. So how do you know if you're camouflaged? So if you hit tab to pull up your hunter mate, hit G and go up to camo view, you can see that I'm gray when I want to be green. That's because I have the field camo on and not the forest. Oops. Okay, she's still squawking. If I had the forest camo on, I'd be pretty well camoed. So because it's a turkey, we've got to be pretty careful with where we're bringing her to, because the closer she gets, the more likely she is to see me and spook. So we're going to try and bring her up this hill. Since it's a female only that's calling, there probably isn't a male there. But we'll see if we can call out. If we use this locator call, you can usually tell if a male's in the area. If there was a male, he probably would have called back by now. So, we're going to use our binos. Kind of look around. Sometimes if you keep it on lower resolution, you'll notice the animals kind of clip through, but then you put out your binos, you're like, oh, the animal's not there. It is, it's just kind of hidden behind something. So we're gonna be patient and see if she comes up the hill, and then we're probably gonna body her with this bad boy. So we can zoom in and out with the mouse wheel. Oh, so you can kind of hear, should be right, there she is. Is that her? Is that you, you bitch? Nope, not yet. but it's coming from this direction. And normally I would crouch hunting turkeys, but just trying to kind of show you guys how to do this. So, oh, there she is in all her glory. And you hold spacebar, so you'll notice I'm gonna scout her. It'll pop up, so we've spotted her. So we get that experience. And we drop her. So I held spacebar there to hold my breath, because you noticed I had a lot of weapon sway. That's because it's a new gun for me. So normally with turkeys, you want to wait till you get a male. But since we were doing that fancy demonstration for you all, I figured I would go out and just kill it. So then you walk up to the animal. If you had wounded it, you would have to track it. Since we obviously crushed it, we will click it and identify it. So we hit it right in the heart, which is where you want to hit it. It gives you the weight, it gives you your CSS score, and then your regular score depending on your animal. So the CSS score is a cross-species score. With a cross-species score, generally speaking, anything around 85 is pretty good to 100, 120. Each species has a different cross-species score and a different score that's considered really good. So it'll take you a long time to learn these, and you can always look them up on the wiki if you need to know what they are. But most grills don't give you a score, as you can tell. So because we used the 223, we probably spooked some things, but I don't know that we spooked them that far. Now, if we would have used a bigger gun, we would have spooked much, much, much more. So like I said, we're going to crouch, and call. So we're going to get rid of our locator call, bring my coyote call back that I want, and then we'll call some different species. Now, because something got spooked, it might take us a few minutes before something responds, but no reason not to call while you're walking. What weapon is best, the Raptor or the 300? So the 7mm Magnum, or the 7mm Raptor, is what I was showing you guys as a semi-auto option. That's a good one. And the 300 is also good. I prefer the 300, but the 7mm is a great gun. I mean, there's no denying it. If you want the extra range, it's probably the way to go. So either one of those are good, Tim. Hi, Jordan. So because I'm going into explaining a lot of the stuff, guys, I won't be paying a lot of attention to chat. Don't take it personally. I'm usually very interactive with chat. It's just because everybody was asking all those questions. I wanted to make sure I did a kind of a tutorial, and then I'll cut this out and post it on YouTube for you all, in case you need to reference anything. So we are going to walk over to my deployable stand. We'll call from there. Notice I'm not even walking. I'm crouching. Now, I could have walked, because typically there's a spook radius. Because I don't know the exact spook radius of the 223, I'm not going to risk it. I'm just going to walk over. You see there's an animal right there. Now, if we would have walked, we wouldn't have been able to get that, because it would have spooked. What are you? Dinner. Oh, hello. Looks like some grill elks. Kind of hard to tell. Again, I'm not in a... Whoop, we were about to spot it. I'm not in a great spot for my camo. Yeah, female elk. Okay. So... since they're grills, we'll switch out so we have an elk call. I won't be able to get to that tower, but I should be able to call them within range. Right. And I'm gonna try and take them out with a bow, but it's really difficult because they're a bigger species, so I gotta get a really, really good shot in order to do it. So you'll notice I'll call, and they'll probably start coming this general direction. Sometimes they head in a straight line from where you call, sometimes they don't, it just kinda depends. This is what I mean about the clipping. I can see that better zoomed out than zoomed in. Okay, here comes that elk. Moving at high speeds, apparently. Jesus. So I'm going to try and stand hidden. Now, this is how the sight works. It's at 49 meters, so I need to use that pin, and I still want to aim at the heart. Thought we had a call there. So she'll come a little closer, but we just want to try and be careful. She doesn't get too close so we don't spook her. Now the disadvantage to the bow is you can only crouch and shoot. You can't go prone. So if something's pretty visual species, it makes it difficult to do that. The crossbow you can go prone with though. Okay, so she may have spooked. It's hard to tell. She was moving so fast that I don't know if we spooked her or not. It could have been. Like, that looks like the elk there. Yeah, there's one there. See, there she goes. Alright, so she called. So there's two of them. Let's see what our camo looks like. Still not very good. So we want to try and let her get close. I'm actually going to work my way around, kind of slowly, see if I can get in that stand and call them to us, which would be much easier. Hopefully she doesn't notice me. See how she's going to the spot where I called? So that should allow me to back up, get in the stand, and then call and see what I can get without spooking her. Ideally, that's how it should go. She's really close, though. The other thing is, if there's any other packs of elk that are around, they're going to that spot, too, within a certain range. So I have to watch to make sure that I don't have any behind me that I didn't see that might spook. So once I get in the stand, I'll be able to call again, and they'll relocate. Oh, shit. Except she may be magnetic, meaning that she's going to me and not the calling site, which I think that's a bug. Normally does not do that. Oh, fuck. See, elk are kind of stupid. You can get kind of close. but I'm out in the open and exposed, so she's probably seen me. She is right next to the stand. If that was a coyote, they would have been long gone. Fox, long gone. Most deer species, long gone. See, we spooked something behind us. There she goes. All right, so whatever spooked behind us is ultimately what scared her off, because she still couldn't see us. Or she did, but she didn't know what we are. So now we can run or walk, since we already spooked everything. And they elk are pretty dumb. They'll come back in pretty quickly. That'll also give us a chance to call in a coyote. Because the coyotes will just randomly show up. Now, if we get a big elk, we'll call it, we'll use a gun. If we get female elks, I'll use the bow. So they already went away. We got our elk call, and we have our predator call. So the predator call calls foxes, and it calls coyotes. The thing about coyotes is they usually don't call back. They just fucking show up like somebody wrecking a party. So, and if they show up, there will be anywhere between 6 and 10 of them, and it's a goddamn turkey shoot. Like, you can shoot them as quickly as you can. That's why I put this stand out in the middle of the field. It's because it's easy to see 360 degrees all the way around. Oh, see, they're already calling back. There's the females. So she's already calling back. We didn't scare her too far, so we'll bring them back. Spooks end after 13 in-game minutes. Thank you. I didn't know the exact time. Thank you very much, dude. Welcome. Welcome, everybody, if you're here for the hunter. I was playing Fishing Planet for a while. That's what most of my videos are, if you see my YouTube channel. By the way, we'll hit 1 million views today, so thank you guys very much for all your support on YouTube. Thank you so much. If you want to check out the channel, we'll hit 1 million views today. So I'll be super stoked when that happens. But anyway, I was playing Fishing Planet. A lot of the guys that like Fishing Planet also like the Hunter. So I promised him I'd do a tutorial. So I apologize if I'm not interacting with chat as much, but I'm doing a tutorial to try and help everybody. That way I can post it to YouTube. So... so if you guys have any additional tips, throw them out in chat, please, and I'll add them to the tutorial. There's that slag out there, looking for action. Trolling for strange. So like in most species, you really don't want the grills, you want the boys, but... for this demonstration, we'll probably take anything. Okay, so now what we want to try and do is try and get a broadside shot, which is going to be difficult. That's the disadvantage to a lot of the tower hunting, is you can't get the shot you usually want to. This won't be bad, though. There. That's not bad. Nah, not what I wanted. Stop moving. All right, that's perfect. All right, that ass. I don't know where she's going. All right, so now you can tell the rangefinder. It highlights where you want to shoot based off the distance. I don't know why she's running around. Typically, they don't do that. She must be somewhat agitated. I hear you, but for some reason you keep running away. All right. She'll be coming in, hopefully. I thought maybe coyotes had spooked her or something, but usually it doesn't matter too much when they come around. So anyway, guys, this is a free-to-play game. If you decide you do want to play it, I'll send you over the refer a friend link. That way you get a little more extras when you sign up for the game. I would highly recommend it. It's a bunch of fun. And like I said in the tutorial I did before I started playing this, is I can kind of give you an idea on what to buy and what not to buy when you just start. Bad angle. So that wasn't a good shot because it went through the shoulder. So you'll notice that she spooked. That's why you want to be able to aim broadside, because if you hit him in the heart, they'll drop immediately. But because I didn't and I hit it almost through the shoulder, it caused her to run more than it should have. However, we have another victim out here. Hello? Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, are you here for the meeting? It's over this way. PTO meetings this way, ma'am. If you could proceed this way. Hi, Spice. I'll call her over and see if I can get her over here. Oh, there's my guys. What up? Worth it. Every coyote's worth it. See what I mean when I say they come out of nowhere? Alright, we just spooked something, but it was worth it. I was gonna try a bow, but I never have a lot of luck. The coyotes move too fast. So we'll go get this grill first. So anyway, coyotes, they show up out of nowhere without calling like that one did. So we called it a few minutes ago and it just shows up and that's what happens. So if you notice with her, we shot her and she dropped a blood trail. So then you see you have this triangle that you need to follow. This triangle points you to where you need to go to find the next track, which will be these globes that you see in front of us. They're highlighted. Now, if you're tracking something and you've shot it or you missed, the tracks you're looking for are fleeing. Because they're going to be running away or you're going to see blood tracks. Those are the ones you want to follow. If you get roaming, hopefully it's been 10 or 15 minutes in-game and it's changed back to roaming. But if it's just like walking around normally, typically those are not the tracks you want to follow. Ignore those. So here's another blood track. You'll notice it tells us to keep going that way. And then you see these over here. And you got another blood track, so you click that. So then you have two globes here. So I would look around. Let's check this one. So this one is roaming. And a solid circle means that it's really close. If it was a dotted one, you wouldn't know how old that shit was that's on the ground right here. It wouldn't be warm. It'd probably be cold. So you wouldn't know how close the animal was. So it becomes a like semicircle or dotted circle. Okay, so there's, see how it changed to where it's dotted? And then we obviously have the animal right here. So that's kind of how you track something. Notice no score, obviously. But we did do a mission, like I said. We did a mission without even trying. So we just finished one. So we got some in-game currency for that. Cinderella coyote out of nowhere, I guess. So then if we go back, we'll check this coyote that we headshotted. Because mostly the male and female coyotes give points. Now, big coyote is 28, 26 kilos. Those are both pretty big coyotes. Now, normally I'd zoom in and I'd pick which one would be better, but he was moving so fast that if he would have gotten any closer to the tower, the coyotes usually spook. He doesn't look bad. That's a she. So we won't get many points for that. Yeah, that's kind of a low CSS and a low score. But we hit it in the neck, the shoulder blade, the right lung, and heart. So that frangible round basically exploded, and that's what happened. So anyway, we've collected all of our bodies that are out here. And we'll move on to where we can call another animal. Now, sometimes I'll hang out in the tower, even though we spooked some stuff. Sometimes I'll still hang out in the tower. Sometimes I won't. It just depends. Sometimes I'll move, like I have turkey blinds set up, and I'll move over to there. Just depends. Call some more coyotes. Again, because I use the 223, it doesn't spook as much as a bigger caliber would. If I use a 300, we'd be waiting. We would have spooked a lot of shit in a much farther radius. So. Looks like we got something moving straight ahead. Kind of hard to see. If you guys look through there, it looks like there's something moving. It's kind of hard to tell. Might not be. It might just be a branch or something, but thing with coyotes though is you have to like keep your head on a swivel like we did because they'll pop up very quickly when you're not expecting them. Mage, do you have any more questions based off of what you've seen so far? Hey, Wordy. Wordy, I'm gonna post this to YouTube since you missed. I spent like probably 30 to 45 minutes explaining how the game works and stuff before I went into a hunt. But we are hunting mostly for elks and coyotes. We gotten a couple so far. We got a turkey too. Yeah, I'll post it tomorrow. I spent a long time like talking about the game and the currency and stuff, so everybody was really patient. So thank you guys again for your patience. I know it was kind of boring before I went into actually a hunt, and even this can be boring sometimes. Looks good, still need to learn a lot about this shit. So, I mean there is a lot to learn. I mean, every day I learn stuff when I play with somebody that has a higher hunter score than me. Like there's this guy that I play with who he has a hunter score of 2,000. And I haven't played with him in a while, but I do know that he's interested in playing again, so he kind of gives me some tips. I should actually check Discord and see if he's on. Maybe he'll help you guys. Hold on. No. Damn, he's not on right now. He's in Australia, so I have no fucking, or no, he's in Tasmania, so I have no idea what time it is there, but he's always willing to help. And you will find a community that, again, is pretty, just like Fishing Planet, they're pretty willing to help you do well. Like Randy had asked for some tips. He just started last week, so I'll make sure to share this with him too, so he can have an idea. These animals are still going to be spooked for a couple minutes, though. Hazard, my hunter score is only like 170s, dude. I've been playing a long time, but I don't really grind hunter score or anything. I mostly play with my friends. Is I'm probably not going to buy a membership. If I play it because I rotate games every day. Oh, dude, that's the best way to buy the membership because I only play it, I mean, 2 or 3 times a week typically. And that's, I'll just buy a 6 month membership and forget about it. Sometimes I go weeks without playing it. But like if I know I'm not going to play a lot of other games, I just buy this to support the game. Welcome, Hazard. Welcome to the stream, everybody. If you guys are new, if you like the Hunter, I do play it pretty often. I just promised some guys from Fishing Planet, which I'm more well known for, that I'd play Hunter for them today and kind of introduce them to the game and some of the stuff I wish I knew. Nikki sometimes takes all the viewers on a goose hunt. Nikki's Goose Hunt Express. Yeah, but that's a waste of money. I disagree, Mage. I really think it's a good game. It's well worth the investment. But do whatever you want to do. It's 7:53 a.m. Sunday morning. Okay, thank you, Wiz. Appreciate it, man. He's probably not up yet. He usually stays up like 2 or 3 in the morning. He was in the stream yesterday or the day before, though. So if he sees me playing the Hunter, I'm sure he'll want to play. Excuse me. So we're going to give it 5 more in-game minutes, guys. And if we don't get something, then we're going to walk back to our turkey blind. And then this is known as like the Golden Tree Stand. It's a really good spot. So we'll go back there. I hate to even call coyotes because the second I get out of the stand, we're going to see him. Nikki, what would you recommend? Oh, there we go. I knew we'd get one eventually. Nikki, what would you recommend for new players? Which bundle would you recommend buying? The membership was good because they gave you the deployable towers. Yeah, see, that's what I say. The 6 or 12 month, if you decide you're going to get into it, you can buy it and forget it and not play for a while. I mean, yeah, but I'll make a lot of money in a month to spend because I'm in a wheelchair. So I need to save some. I understand that, man. Definitely understand that. If you decide you just want to try it out, it's like buying a game for $15 for the 3 month package. See if you like it. But I'll stream it for you to see if you like it. Some people like to watch games more than they even like to play them sometimes, but this should be coming. But either way, Mage, hopefully that stuff helped you. The tutorial and everything. It can allow you to at least make an educated decision. Still sounds good. Probably going to buy it eventually when I get back on my feet. Still 5 months rehab. What happened, Mage? If we can ask. It's not too personal. If you don't have a lot of money to spend, just get the 3 month package and buy the guns once a month. Oh, that's a good idea, Nikki. Yeah. That's what I like about the economy is that it's like a la carte. So you can buy whatever the hell you want. Oh, there we go. Baby grill. Wandering around. Going the wrong fucking way. When the call is over here. Alright, bitch. I hear you, but why don't you come out? You're just out here. I don't understand what your deal is. Car accident with motorcycle. Sorry for bad English. Hat on crash because of the drunken ass moron. Oh, God. Sorry to hear that, man. That sucks. And there's nothing easy to say. There's nothing more I can say about that. I was in a wheelchair for 6 months. I tore every ligament and tendon in my left ankle. I was supposed to be in one. I just used crutches after about a month because I got around a little better. Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that. That was the one thing my dad said to me that I was never allowed to have is a motorcycle. I was allowed to get dirt bikes, but I could never drive a motorcycle because he had basically the same situation. He got in an accident when somebody felt, quote unquote, fell asleep because it was back in like the 80s. So who knows if he fell asleep or was wasted. 2 week coma? Oh shit. Get fucked. Alright, moving on. Holy shit, 2 week coma. So what's your recovery gonna look like? Is everything gonna be okay once you're out of the wheelchair? Hey bitch, get back here. Free elk dongs over here. Elk weasels. Free. Bye, Blaze. See you tomorrow, dude. Is that a boy? No, that's not a boy. Nope. Stupid girl. Damn it, guys. We can't get any big elks today. Thing with the males, they come in packs like the girls do. And usually like anywhere from three to six, they're a little more rare, but fuck, some of them are huge. Rab says hello, guys. Nikki, he told you to go fuck yourself. That's why I was laughing. Actually, I may have ad-libbed that a little bit. It's kind of crazy they don't give you a 30-round magazine for the 223. I guess that'd be a little OP. At least a 10-round mag would have been nice. These are shitty small 5-rounders. Why don't you turn broadside for me there? Toots. Oh. Fucking mouthy. Oh, god damn it. God damn it. Apparently that tower spooks them a little more than the other tower normally would. Alright, let's see if there's a male back there. And we'll call in these turkeys. Say it's gonna be fine, but still have some issues with walking for a while after the wheelchair. My eyesight's probably not gonna be better, but I can live with it. I'm alive. That's awesome, man. You have a great, like, outlook on life. That's awesome. Good for you. A lot of people would have, like, a chip on their shoulder. That's great. Rab's just mad I won't play stupid-ass tanks with him anymore. Yeah, nobody really plays that with him anymore. We're going to play Arma later today, the Exile mod. You guys missed it. Oh, God. I wish it was on stream. We popped... So, Rab and I was in the trunk, and Brennan was driving, and Rab was in the passenger seat. And Brennan was like, oh, shit, a quad. Let's go steal it. And he went over to steal the quad, and some guy was using it as bait and came out and popped him and killed both of them. Well, he didn't know that I was in the trunk. I came out of the trunk and fucking sprayed him. And, well, I didn't save the day because everybody else was dead, but it made me feel good about myself. That was pretty awesome. There's some pretty good role-playing that was going on, too. And I don't mean dom sub, Nikki, before you ask, pervert. Alright, there we go. Atta girl. Atta baby. Good job. Alright. Well, she's coming from back here. Oh, this will be way easier to see. Probably coming up that hill. But I don't think she's got any boys with her, which means I'll just ignore her. Like, no points, no reason to hunt it down. Or to wait. Spice, you missed it, man. Like, they even were saying, they're like, oh my god, I can't believe you didn't record that on stream. Like, they were both dead. The guy goes up to loot the bodies. I just walk out of the trunk and fucking sprayed the shit out of him. And all I see, like, 60 seconds later, you see in chat, what the fuck? You could get in trunks now? Stupid bitch. I replied back, you stupid pussy. Get fucked. Dumb motherfucker. Oh, 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 oh.
this shit in.
Oh, man, you guys would have loved it. That guy was so pissed off. There's nothing I love better than pissing people off in that game. There's another one back there. What is that? Might be a deer. I don't think that's an elk. Either way, it's another grill. Kind of sucks. Alright, we'll just shoot this one with a bow if it gets close enough, guys. I'm gonna call a coyote just to see if we can entertain ourselves until this turkey gets here. And then after we kill this, we'll move to another spot. This spot's kind of... It's good, but not enough to give you guys some action. Oh man, Spice, you would have loved it. I wish you could have saw it. Rab laying there dead. Like, avenge me. And I fucking pop out of the trunk and just shot the shit out of that guy. He was so pissed. Dude, it must be fucking ladies' night out here, because there are no male animals anywhere to be found. Another one out there? So if we had a 22 Plinkington, we could shoot this and it would really make no noise. But not as easy with a 223. Oh, Spice, it was so fucking funny. They died, and they had to walk so far, but they were still celebrating how awesome it was. Because I told them it would work, and they didn't think of it. And then all of a sudden they die, and they're like, oh shit, you're still in the trunk, just wait. I was like, yeah, of course I'm going to wait, retards. So I waited, and waited, till as soon as I saw him start to loot, I popped out of the trunk, and just... It was awesome. It was fucking awesome. You know, there's moments in video games that just make you smile every time you think of them. That's going to be one of them for a while. He was so pissed. How far out are you? Still 50 meters, a little far. Don't see the coyotes anywhere, though. Sorry, we'll move spots in a minute. Fucking bitch. Mouthy, mouthy bitch. We're gonna play Arma later today, Spice, so maybe you can see some highlights. It's pretty fucking funny. I had RP'd a doctor who was pissed because his luggage was lost. After, because in Arma, you know, they have those luggage cars that you see at the airport that drive the luggage around. And I just walked up, some guy was driving one around. I walked up to him. I said, "I just came in from the red eye from Philadelphia. I baggage claim 3. Do you have any luggage with you? Like, did you find any luggage?" It ends up being this little kid, and he starts to try an RP, and he's doing his best. And I RP'd it for like 15 minutes, and he won't leave me alone now every time I go on that server. He's a really nice kid, but he was laughing really hard when I was telling him. I had to file a customer complaint, and I had a meeting with Mr. Stansberry at 9:30 in the night, and it was a very important meeting. And now I had clothes with shit all over them, so he actually gave me his ghillie suit. He said, "Here, sir, just to make up for me losing your luggage." He handed me his ghillie suit. Not that he even lost it, but it was funny. Good try. Try and take off and drop. Doesn't get old. That's fucking awesome. That never gets old when you shoot a fucking turkey with a bow and it tries to take off. It's great. Oh yeah. I mean, I snake oiled sails the shit out of that guy. That wasn't the right thing I wanted to say, but you know what I mean. I'm gonna try and avoid that deer. I want nothing to do with it. We're just gonna see if we can go get some either turkeys or coyotes, guys, from the blind. The only reason I'm collecting these is because they add to your hunter score and your skills with the certain weapons. So. Oh, deer. Ah, but it's female. I won't even bother with it. How has your stream been going, Spice, since you've been on Twitch, man? By the way, guys, if you want a good streamer to follow, please follow my friend Spice. He's in charge of all the write-ups in the channel. But you should follow him. He has the best hair on Twitch. That's been confirmed. So I would highly recommend following him. He's been playing Diablo mostly, a lot lately. Hashtag best hair on Twitch. Yep. You need to hashtag everything that you do. Like on Twitter, you just need to hashtag that and make sure that everyone realizes it. We're gonna walk this blind, guys. Then I'll call some coyotes and some turkeys and see what we can get. I'll start adding it to your tweets. It's a good idea. You should do that. Get some exposure out there. Nah, I don't want that white-tailed deer. Hashtag flyby turkey. Yeah. That turkey took off, but that was his last flight, and it didn't last long. The only problem is that I gotta walk so slow to that blind where all those decoys are, but usually it's a great spot to get turkey and coyotes, so it'll be worth. So again, if you guys are new, don't hesitate to shout out some questions. I can help, at least for the new stuff. If you're more advanced, probably can help a little bit. We are approximately 1 month away from our vacation, boys, for our next shark trip, second trip of the year. Hoping the fishing will be way better in the fall because the summer was slow. We'll see how it goes. Hi, Sage. Welcome back, man. Bye, Mage. See you later, man. I'll post this on YouTube for you tomorrow morning, dude. Dude, Sage, it's been a minute. How are you doing, man? How's everything going? You're welcome. Damn. There's a blacktail right in front. It's a girl. Can't get a boy, guys, to save our lives. Somebody get Mexi in here, please. I'm trying not to call because I don't want to run into anything in the woods. It needs to be a little more open. Hey, Braden, what's up? Obsidian, what's up? How are you guys doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh, there's that deer. So there's our decoys. There's our blind. Hurt my back like 2 months ago. It's been up and down. Oh, dude, I'm sorry to hear that. Hope you feel better. That is shitty. Dude, I'm sorry. That sucks, Sage. You tweak something in your back, it can be months before it gets better. And a lot of times the doctors don't even know how to help you. Oh shit, that's close. There it is. Trying to avoid spooking him. Don't think we spooked him, but maybe we did. Hard to tell. Either way, we'll get in the blind and start to call. Fishing in BDO, kicking back. What's BDO? Should I know that? Oh, Black Desert. I didn't know they had fishing in that. Makes you want to consider looking at it, but blacktail are here, okay. Is there any new stuff? Yeah, there's quite a bit of new animals. If you haven't played in a long time, like there's a winter map, they've added some bird species. Bird species kind of suck. They're adding the Rocky Mountains. That's a new map that's going to be in. Some new guns, you know, the usual stuff. Is Black Desert free to play? It's probably not. Good, Sage. That's awesome, man. You have a good outlook on that. We'll call elk, we'll call turkeys and deer and Yeah, Rocky Mountains was one of the ones on the survey that was like really high. It's like the second or third, or the first or second option for a lot of people and what they wanted to see. It's not free to play. It's still becoming pay to win, even though it's not free to play. Oh boy. That's not good. I do like fishing in MMOs. It's one of my hobbies. But now I have like Fishing Planet, so I don't need to fish like in WoW or whatever all the time. Yeah, Arcage. I bought the Founders Pack for that. Still kind of regret. It was really fun for a few weeks, though. Not worth, but really fun for a few weeks. Oh, it's a male. What up? Is that non-typical? That looks typical. It's not bad for a blacktail. Don't turn that way, you bitch. You bitch. Fuck. Don't tell me I didn't drop you. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Did I hit him in the head when he shook his head? There's no way. Don't tell me it says body. Intestines? Oh, come the fuck on. Come the fuck on. This thing isn't even dead. Son of a bitch. What's the best weapon in this game? Hard to define best, Sage. God damn it, intestines. Fuck me. The best value is probably either the shotgun or one of the bows. It's like almost every gun, if you're using it for the species, kills something. So it's really based on value and preference. Fuck me, I can't believe that didn't kill him. Intestines, my ass. It did not hit him in the fucking intestines. Look at that pile of shit. Jesus, somebody had Chipotle. Ugh. Good God. Sorry guys, I had to change it up to walk a little faster to find the track. That's crazy that I didn't kill him. Fuck. There's a delay? What do you mean, Braden? I agree, Obsidian, completely. That's why I play it. Not even bleeding anymore. He'll still be standing. Oh, nope, it is. He may have had a slow, untimely death, but at least if he's running to water. We know he went one or two directions, one or the other. Was that him? Nope. Fuck. This is why we crouch walk. By me, thank you for being here. Which one do you like best except the composite bow? The 300 Win Mag, the 12 gauge shotgun, the bow I'm using now, the Parker Python. The 22 is good for a lot of the small species. I mean, there's so many things that are really good for certain species. No, I'm not really in any summer fiesta. I was just doing a video to try and help newer players. Back there. Didn't I already get that one? The fuck's the nearest? Well, that's a different. That's probably a male deer, too. That track. This is why I don't recommend tracking, boys. I should have just shot it with a rifle. But Is just trying to show off for the stream. Males usually I shoot with rifles and don't worry about it. Because it was only a blacktail, I didn't think too much about it. The other track. It's got to be one way left or right. Must not be this direction. Isn't tracking like really hard in this game? No, it's tough. This way, Wordy? I couldn't see the globe if it was this way, like what I'm supposed to track. I may have missed it, but the only deer that was here was a female. To the right of where you walk down? Okay. If you're talking about the deer that was over here, it's a female. Oh, there it is. You're right. Thank you. Thanks, Wordy. That Hawkeye, though. Yeah, it would be cool if you could just pull it out. Like, hey, now we need you. Or like carried around in a cage or something. I don't know, that's not very realistic, I guess. If we find this thing again and it's alive, we're just gonna shoot it with a rifle. Left, look left. Don't see anything left. Still bleeding. Probably didn't even survive 1 minute. Yeah, probably not. There's a lot of trails right here. Oh, there we go, boys. Shout out to Wordy. It's a typical. Not bad. There's no way I hit that thing right there. No way. I hit it right here, and its head was down.